Hello dear students, we will move on to the study of binomial distribution. Okay, after we solved one question relating to textbook and also one example relating to how to solve when at least, at the most, more than, less than relating to that concept. Now we are going to solve problems relating to the same concept. Okay. This is first question. Okay, the probability that a bomb hits a target is 1/2. Okay, 4 bombs are aimed at a bridge. Okay, 3 bombs are enough to destroy the bridge. Okay, find the probability that, okay, the first question they ask, okay, the bridge is destroyed. The second question is none of the bombs hit the bridge. This is the question. First, we have to identify the value of P and small n value. Here, they given, okay, the probability that a bomb hits a bridge, okay, hits a target is 1/2. It means the P value is 1/2, or you can also divide it by, okay, 1/2, then you will get, okay, 0.5. Then, how many bombs are aimed at the bridge? That is the value of small n. So, but what is given here? 4 bombs are aimed at a bridge, but 3 bombs are enough to destroy that bridge. But ultimately, we considering here, okay, 4 bombs. We are not consider, okay, 3 bombs, because when we aim 4 bombs at the bridge, okay, then only that bridge will be destroyed. Okay, 3 bombs are enough, but 4 bombs are aimed at the bridge. So that's why the small n value is 4 and the P value is 1/2. So first let us determine what is S. It means when we take, okay, X value in the formula, then what it indicates X means. So X means, okay, number of bombs hit the bridge, okay, when 4 bombs are aimed at the bridge. Okay, this is very very important. First we determine, or first we describe, okay, what is X. So then X is a binomial variable with the parameter n comma p. Okay, you know very well the parameter of a binomial distribution. So then the PMF, it means the probability mass function, is, so p x equals to n c x, okay, p raised to x, q raised to n minus x. The range of x is determined or defined only by the maximum value of small n. Okay, so 0, 1, 2 up to n. It means andre x value vanna neevu elli varige tegekondu hogabahudu antandre small n in a value elli varige irutte alli varige enpa antandre neevu x value vanna tegekolbahudu. So given that small n equals to 4, p equals to 1/2, they are already given in the question. So 1/2, 0.5. then how to find out q? You know very well, 1 minus p, okay, you will get, okay, q value. So 1 minus 0.5, then ultimately you will get 0.5 is also q value. Here p value is also 0.5 and q value is also 0.5. in this case, okay, I will explain that concept, okay, later, okay, how we have to take the x value in this moment. Okay, then we have to put the x value, okay, after calculation. Then small n means 4cx, okay, p is 0.5 raised to x, and q is also 0.5 raised to 4 minus x. The value of x is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It means up to 4 we can take x value, not more than that 4. Okay, first question is the bridge is destroyed. First question in part, the bridge in part, the destroyed after the end of the bridge yava destroyed after the part, the now 4 bomb galanna aim aayikondi idaga matra aa bridge in part, the destroyed after the aa au prakar in part, the 3 bombs are enough to destroy that bridge. So we consider, okay, P equals to x equals to 3 plus P, okay, x equals to 4. It means we have to consider x value 3 plus x value 4. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ನೀವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂವನ್ನ 3 ಹಾಕಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಇನ್ನೊಮ್ಮೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂವನ್ನ 4 ಹಾಕಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಎರಡರದ್ದು ಬಂದ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಸೊ 4c3 ಓಕೆ 0.5 raised to 3, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ 3. ಸೊ 0.5 raised to 3. ನೌ ಓಕೆ 0.5 raised to 4 minus 3, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು x equal to 3, when we take x equal to 3. Then 4c4, okay, 0.5 raised to 4 and 0.5 raised to 4 minus 4. This is relating to when x equals to 4. After simplifying this, okay, 4c3, okay, you will get the value 4. Then 0.5, you have to multiply 0.5, okay, 3 times, then you will get, okay, 0.125. Then 0.5, here 4 minus 3 is there, so 4 minus 3, 1, so 0.5 into 1 means you will get the same answer, okay, 0.5. Then put okay plus as it is, 4c4, the ultimately result you will get okay, 1, 0.5, you have to multiply this 4 times, then you will get 0.0625, then 0.5, raised to 4 minus 4 is there, so don't take okay 0, then we have to consider 1 in that place. So add these two answers, okay, add these two answers here, okay, 4 into 0.125 into 0.5, you will get okay result is 0.25, okay. Then this, okay, 1 into 0.0625 into 1, then you will get the result 0.0625. By adding these two answers, you will get, okay, 0.3125. This is, okay, one way of calculating this question. And another method is also there, when P value, okay, 1 by 2 or when P value is 0.5 and also Q value is 0.5 or 1 by 2. On that moment, it is so simple how to calculate on that moment. This concept applicable only when P value is 0.5 and also Q value is 0.5. Then only this concept will be applicable, okay. In other cases, this concept will not be applicable. ಈ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ 0.5 ಒಂದೇ ಟೈಮ್ ತಗೊಂಡು 0.5 ನ ಒಂದೇ ಟೈಮ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರ ಎನ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತೋ ದ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಲಿಮಿಟ್